everybody. It is Tuesday and it's 2 o'clock. So normally I'm live Top 5 Tuesday. Today's a little bit of a different day because I am here at Bristol Motor Speedway. I'm actually going to So you can see I'm in the vendor area let's see here what we've got. There we go. There's the track way up there. And it's a lot of fun here at Bristol Motor Speedway. So I guess I'll flip my camera around. I'm here with some friends for sure. Let's see, I've got my friends over here at AFCO. So Ben Baker over there at AFCO. And we're gonna get a wave here from Andy Garris is waving at us here. There we go. And of course it's backwards because I need to flip the camera. So go back into selfie mode and then things will be right sized. My friends from Daytona One right over there in the corner. And just beyond that is Dirt Car Lift. So a lot of fun here this is the first time Crate Insider that we've set up a booth at an event. So this is all new. We've got the new van back here with the Crate Insider. I'm just gonna take you guys around. So the new van has Crate Insider all, sorry about the camera angle, guys. I'm just kind of, you know, just rolling with what I got going on here. So there is the new Crate Insider van that is packed full of a bunch of stuff. So I'm pretty excited about that for sure. And then I have a booth here as well. And let's take a look at some of the things. And, you know, I just kind of brought some of the most popular things that we sell. Sorry, I'm getting hung up on my pit bike over here. But when we take a look here, obviously, I'm here with my friends from Daytona One, and we've got all the Daytona One products. Buck and I will be doing a video later on, and that I'll publish when I get back home, showing the Timken bearing machine right there. So there's the Timken bearing machine, which will show and really demonstrate how the engine treatment works and how it protects your engine and how it protects your bearings. Now, I also brought over here, I've got my Kaiser wheels right there. I've got some, you know, a lot of these products that you guys see on a weekly basis on Top 5 Tuesday. We've got some Firewire here, got a bunch of t-shirts, and definitely race fans. Race fans have been a go-to item since I got here for this weekend. So it's really, I would say probably our top-selling product here this weekend guess it's Tuesday, right? But the top-selling product of the week has definitely been race fans. It's a go-to product for sure. And then over here too, let's see. Oh, Allgaier bump stops. I mean, I've been talking about those on the show for a while. And just to do a little demo here, this Allgaier bump stop, if you're somebody who can use bump stops, then you know that you go through a bump stop, they last a couple of races and they start getting weaker and you just can't count on them. But this is a special polyurethane. It's really, really tough stuff. Really, really tough. And you can even cut, if you need a shorter bump stop, you can cut it off shorter if that's what you want to do. But definitely hold on to those pieces, because if you need pressure later on, you can just actually add that on to the stack and you're still going to get great pressure. But then this whole kit also comes with these packers. So let me show you what these do. So these packers right here, it's like plastic. It's got a little tab on it. And you would slide it in here. It will clip. But then I'd have to have a needle nose, and I brought lots of tools, but I didn't bring a needle nose with me. But it'll just clip in there, and then you can pull it out with a needle nose, but that'll add extra spring pressure. So the Allgaier bump stops, they are such a popular product right now. If there is one, like, new product that I've learned about here recently, it's from going to the RaceLogic chassis schools and learning about Allgaier bump stops. So that has definitely been a go-to, so I'm really glad to be able to bring those to the show this week. Let's see what else I brought. I brought some carb spacers. Definitely brought, obviously, you guys know I love, love, love tools. So I brought the LSM valve spring tools right over here. So I've got the valve spring changer, the valve spring checker, they have the valve lash adjusting tool. And, you know, this is one of my favorite go-tos. I have this in my office. You know, many of you know that I don't have a race car. So there's a lot of these products that I might love for my customers, but you know, for me, I don't have any use for them, really. You know, I mean, they're for my customers to win. But every once in a while, I come across a product that I'm like, oh my God, I have to have this. So this is one of them, and it's the AN pit wrench. And I use it for all kinds of things. So, you know, if you ever use a crescent wrench, and you know how they get all wonky, you know, when you're trying to turn something, because this worm here has an extra little spiral in it, it just holds in place, and so it doesn't slide all over the place. So yes, it's an AN wrench, but I use it for anything that I would need a crescent wrench for. Also, on the other end here, this is a tool for, you know, being able to undo Zeus fasteners. But I find that there's a ton of stuff where I just need something straight. And if this is handy, instead of grabbing a screwdriver, I've just got something flat. And, you know, a lot of times camera equipment especially will often have just like that one slot. So this really comes in handy. And it is really super handy also to have this little belt loop. This will just go right around my belt loop very, very easily. So definitely like that as well. So this is the AN pit wrench from LSM. So this is a little slightly different Top 5 Tuesday than what we normally have, but we're going to just talk about some of the products that I have on the table. So the AN pit wrench, it runs $99.95, but definitely a great choice. Now I've got a whole nother, oh, did I show my wheels? I don't know if I showed my wheels. So I've got wheels right here too. I am always, you guys know, I am so in love with the Kaiser wheels. I love the Kaiser wheels with the black powder coated centers because, well, I mean, you all know, I'm trying to straighten out my tripod here, but you all know I'm with aluminum wheels. We want them to be super lightweight. And when we have the aluminum finish, they look great for like 5 minutes. You know, you race them once, you pressure wash them, and then they just don't look shiny anymore. So with the powder coat, really helps them to stay looking newer for far longer. And so I do love the Kaiser wheels for that. All right, let's go to the other table here. And I brought from my friends over at Superior Bearing, I had brought some Wide 5 bearings. There we go. So I have Wide 5 bearing kits just in case, you know, if some people are blowing out bearings here, I wanted to help them be prepared. And then I've got this whole Bell helmet display as well. So the helmet that I brought with me is going to be the RS7. This is the RS7. It's a matte black finish. So obviously I have these in stock. I do have these on the website. So if you're not at Bristol and you want to pick up a helmet, I have these in the 58s and 59s. So 7 1/4 and 7 3/8. I have both of those styles in stock. Well, you know, unless I sell them out here. So the list price on these is $7.99. And I'm giving a little bit of a deal here at the show that I can't announce publicly. So just part of one of those things like the minimum advertised pricing. But come by my booth if you happen to be here, and I'll definitely hook you up. So it's always nice to touch and feel these. Very nice, lightweight, and great helmet. And these are all the 2020 spec. So if you have an older helmet, I mean, definitely look at what you have. Any of the newer helmets came out in October. And so that October 2020, and that spec will be in place for the next 5 years. Our next SFI spec is going to be 2025. So, you know, definitely take a look at the date on your helmet, because if it's back in the 2010s, if it's a 2010 helmet, you could have bought it up to 2015. That's at least a 5-year-old helmet. And if you've had any impacts, you know, there may be some damage that you're not aware of. So that's just my safety tip for today. Let's see what else I brought. I brought some SC1. I also brought some outerwears and some day lube here for sure. I also brought I was hoping to see my friend Dave Hammond. Of course, we're super great friends, and his caster camber gauge kit is just off the chain as far as being able to figure out your caster and your camber and really dial that in. And what Dave really designed, he's got this whole kit right here. I needed to show this on the show more often. But he designed this bracket right here, and this goes onto your ball joint, and then you can use, it comes with this intercomp gauge, this intercomp angle finder is what this is, an intercomp angle finder, which slides right in there, and then that way you can check out your caster, you can check out your camber, and you can do it all right there. You've got all of these just different attachments, so depending on what kind of car you have, what your situation is, then it's all right here, so you can figure all that out. So the caster camber gauge kit, that runs $199. Now, you know that there's no way that I would be leaving the house and coming out to an event without bringing some Crate Insider flat air filter bases. So definitely had to bring the flat air filter base and the lids and the rings. And, you know, and this is just some of the questions that I get asked, just to answer them here. Does this work well for a 2-barrel carburetor? And unfortunately, the answer is no, it does not work as well. But especially if you have a 4-barrel carburetor, especially if it's a billet center section, it works incredibly well. We have tested this against a lot of the, you know, we never like to throw anybody under the bus. So I don't say anything about products that don't work as well or that aren't as effective. I really only focus on the stuff that is really, really well, it works really well and is effective. So when I sell this flat air filter base right here, sell it with this seal ring. It's a half inch seal ring. And you can see this is, you know, we wouldn't want to be male to male. You can't connect those. So this has a little groove inside of this seal ring right here. And this just slides in here. Now it's just kind of sliding around. Throw some silicone on there to glue those together. And then this part right here has a rubber O-ring gasket. And that's going to sit right there on your carburetor very easily. And then once you put your air filter on top, you put the lid on top of that, and then you've got your air cleaner stud. It's going to secure all of that to your carburetor and keep it really nice and tight. And this will, it's very effective, like I said, in those four barrel situations, especially if you have a billet center section in your carburetor. All right, well, let's see what else. I brought some spark plugs. You know, we love our NGK spark plugs here. And I also brought a couple of special things that, you know, you kind of want to see in person when you're buying them. And one of those is our MPI steering wheels. This one happens to be my favorite. This one's a 15 inch, it's dished. And what I really love about this one is the centerpiece right here, how it's got that orange tape. And it really helps you to, you know, really be able to see where your wheel's at a glance. And the one thing I've heard, I've been talking to a lot of racers here this week about steering wheels. And, you know, I had somebody come up and they said, you know, I can buy a steering wheel for, you know, $30, $40. And when I look at this steering wheel, it's $249. Like, it's hard for me to justify. So I started asking around, and I started asking racers, because I have racers coming by saying, you know what, I have an MPI steering wheel. I have it in both my cars. I have two side-by-sides. I use it in all of those. And I was like, you know what, please tell me, what makes it so special? You know, what is the difference? And it's just the quality. It's just so, it's such great quality, and they can feel really confident. So the MPI steering wheels, I'm very excited to bring those here. I'm also brought out some of our Raceiver products. You know, our Raceiver items. We've got some headsets here, but then also the receiving items. And this is one I've gotten a lot of questions about, and this is the Raceiver Element. And one thing that's really nice about the Element is that this is USB charged. So instead of having batteries or worrying about batteries, you just plug this into the wall with a USB. I know for somebody like me, where I have so many devices that are all charged by USB, this would be my solution if I was buying one of these for myself, would definitely be the USB charge. It'll take about 4 hours to charge it for the first time. One question I'll need to follow up with Raceiver is how long that charge lasts. I'm not 100% sure, but one thing is really cool about it. We checked yesterday and it does have a battery life indicator on it. So just like on your phone, whether you've got 5 bars or 4 bars or 3 bars, this has a battery indicator so you know how much charge you have on your receiver here. So definitely, you know, I'm a big fan of the Raceiver Element. I love how it also comes with this little case right here, little zipper case. It's got the holster and your whole deal there. And then of course I've got headphones and everything. You can use any kind of headphones with that as well. So it sounds like there might be, we've got the national anthem being played. I definitely didn't mean to interrupt that. I didn't know that was going on. So I'm not trying to be rude by any means. You might hear the national anthem around me, but we're here right now. I may not be able to see questions, but I will try to take a look afterwards. If you guys have any questions, feel free to drop them in and I will be more than happy to answer them if I can. I'm not doing giveaways this week. We'll do a giveaway next week for sure. And maybe we'll double down and do lots of great giveaways next week. But I am going to wrap it up since we do have the national anthem going. Oh, I guess it just ended. So let's see what else. I think that is all I have. I am having a little bit of fun here, running around in my pit bike right here. Love my little pit bike there. So I guess I don't know who's. Are we still singing? Okay, yeah, it's really loud. Great, awesome. Well, I want to thank you all for being here. This has been a fun show. I'll be doing some more videos this week. If you have any requests for anything you'd like to, any questions you'd like to ask any of the manufacturers, go ahead and drop them in. And I will be sure to ask them. I'll be doing an interview with Cody over at Dirt Car Lift. Obviously, I'll be talking to Buck and I'll be talking to Andy at ProFab and maybe a few other people. And if you're a driver who's here and you're a customer, come on by and let's just chat. And if we want to do an interview, then we can certainly do that too. So thank you all for being here. Thank you for being part of the show. And I will be back in the office next Tuesday at 2:00. Have a great week.